horizontal, as shown. Find out the total velocity of this point. Relative to the center of mass, which direction will go? Down like this. And how much will be this velocity? R by 2 into omega. Right? R by 2 into omega, which is what? Vcm by 2 only. Okay? So this is R by 2 into omega. And I have to add Vcm on it. This velocity I have to add. Okay? And this angle is how much? How much? This is 90. This is how much? 60. So this is 60 degrees. Okay? So I have to add two vectors. One vector is this, other vector is that. This is VCM and this is VCM by 2. And this angle is 60 degrees. Can you find out now? Total velocity will be? You know how to add two vectors? Root over a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta. Do it. Root of VCM square plus VCM square by 4 plus 2 into VCM square by 2 cos of 60. So this is root over VCM square plus VCM square by 4 plus VCM square by 2. How much is this?
VCM by 2.
What? VCM root 7 by 2. Okay? So it becomes very simple to first observe with respect to center of mass and then add what center of mass is doing to find the total velocity. Any doubt? Okay. Now let's see with acceleration what we can do. This is an object which is accelerating with angular acceleration alpha and linear acceleration a. Right? You need to find the acceleration of these four points quickly. plus A. Yes or no? Alpha R here minus A. This is alpha R. This is A. Here is alpha R and there is A. Okay? Tell me what is wrong here. Centripetal acceleration we are ignoring. We are ignoring centripetal acceleration. All of you understand this? Okay? If something is moving in a circle, there will be centripetal acceleration also. Fine? For that, I need to know the velocity. V square by R is the centripetal acceleration. Okay? But tangential acceleration, at this point, the centripetal acceleration will be towards the center like this. So tangential will be A minus alpha R of this point. What about tangential acceleration of this point? How much it will be? Alpha R. Tangential will be alpha R. Tangent is this direction. Radial is that direction. Tangential acceleration of that is alpha R. Radial will be A minus V square by R. V square by R is towards the center. Everywhere towards the center. Are you getting it? This point tangential acceleration is alpha R plus A. Radial is V square by R. This point tangential is alpha into R. Radial is A plus V square by R. Okay? So, these are the small, small nuances you have to take care when you deal with the entire rigid body. Okay? Any doubts till now? Anything? And all these, whatever we are discussing, it is not part of any textbook. I am just telling you how you can analyze if something comes like this in, as a problem. Okay? Any doubts? Alright, next please write down. Pure rolling. Or rolling without slipping. Tell me which all objects can roll. Circle, cylinder, sphere, ring, disc, all these can roll. So basically the cross section should be what? Circular. When you look it from front, it should look like a circle. Only these objects can roll. Fine? But can ellipse roll? Ellipse can roll. Ellipse can roll. But when it rolls, the axis moves up and down. That is not in our syllabus. Okay? Axis should translate. Fine? So we have only the circular cross section as a rolling in our syllabus. Okay? So when you see a rolling object, suppose it is rolling on a surface, like rolling will be, yeah, suppose it will be on the surface, right? So it is rolling on a surface, and when it rolls, it will have some angular velocity omega, yes or no? And the center of mass will also have some velocity, let's say V. Center of mass will move forward or not? Yes. Right? And what is the condition for this rolling? There should not be any slipping. Now first let us discuss when slipping happens. When the slipping happens? I suppose you have two objects in contact like this. When the slipping will happen? Right now slipping is happening. No slipping is happening. Now slipping is happening. So what is the condition for slipping? Suppose friction is not there. It will lose contact. Suppose there is no friction between my two hands. I can still move my two hands together. No slipping. What is relative? Correct. No slipping means that relative velocity between the two surfaces is zero. Lego. No slipping is a condition in which at a point of contact, the relative velocity between the object and the surface is zero. Wherever it is having a contact, there the relative velocity should be zero. Relative velocity zero means what? The velocity of one surface is equal to the velocity of the other. So at a point of contact, velocity of the object should be equal to the velocity of the surface. Are you getting it? Fine? And abhi tera wo hata usko sabse baja raha hai usko ghante hai. Every 5 minutes he just does like that. Okay, so kya bol raha tha na, what I was saying? So most of the time the objects will roll on the stationary surface or not. Suppose on the ground it is moving on, or on an inclined plane it is moving. The ground is at rest, inclined plane will be at rest, right? So most of the time surface will be at rest. So what should be the velocity of the object at a point of contact for no slipping?
Zero.
Zero. Right? The surface is at rest. So at a point of contact, the velocity or the acceleration, whatever it is, should be zero. If there is no slipping. Got it? Arrangement. Which point is in contact for this object? This point is in contact, and what is its total velocity? What is its velocity? Kya velocity is it? What is the velocity? Dhyan Shreyas will tell. You seem lost today. Kya kisne kya log mein dubao hai? What are you thinking? So bataye hume. What is the velocity of this point of contact?
V plus.
He is telling you which is not correct. Okay, whatever he told you is not correct. Apply your thoughts and tell me what is the answer. Point of contact velocity is what?
Zero.
In terms of V and R omega, what is the velocity of the point of contact? Agar tu either a aspirant. Come, sit front, you are not paying attention. I am worried. See, worried my face. Come. Pay attention, you are not going to learn this with any way easier, okay? If you don't pay attention here, listen. Don't pay attention. You will never learn this. And I have seen it. Past 10 years I am seeing this. Got it? What is the velocity of point of contact? R omega minus V, right? R omega this way and this is V. Okay, so total velocity is R omega minus V. This should be equal to what? Zero. This should be equal to zero, right? So V will be equal to R omega. So if we write down, if the surface is at rest, for no slipping, V should be equal to R omega. For no slipping, V should be equal to R omega if the surface is at rest. Doesn't matter what kind of surface it is, inclined surface, horizontal surface, vertical surface, doesn't matter. V will be equal to R omega if the surface is at rest. Okay? Well, what about with respect to acceleration? Suppose acceleration is A and angular acceleration is alpha. It is differentiated, we get A is equal to R alpha. Getting it? So these are the conditions for it to not to slip. These are like constraint relations, which have nothing to do with physics actually. It is mathematical constraint. Suppose the object is rolling without slipping, this should be true. Okay? So till now there was no relation between VCM and omega. VCM can exist independently and omega can exist independently of whatever value of each. But if it has to do the pure rolling without slipping, there is a condition between VCM and omega. First time they are constrained to have a relation. Getting it? Alright? Similarly with acceleration, A is equal to R alpha. Okay? Now what if the surface in contact is not at rest? Suppose this is kept on this, which is moving with velocity V1 and acceleration is A1. Can you tell me what is the relation now? I still remember. One day, our lab assistant was not present. He was on leave. I told you. Lady, kya kar rahe ho? What lady? So he appointed, probably that point in time, the social science teacher, who was my favorite teacher, was available that point. And so he was like, okay, please take care of these kids in a lab only we're sitting. And this guy was doing his work. And you know, kids, like when I was a kid, and you at your age, not at your age, it was when I was in class 9. So if you just tell us to sit without doing anything, that's the hardest thing to do. Right? You know? I mean, suppose you are making noise, I'll tell you to write this definition, that definition, you'll keep quiet. So you're like, okay, sit. So we'll make noise. So he came and really beat me that day very hard. And I still remember that. Okay? But then he has grown. So I found him in Facebook sometime. Anyways, listen here. So V is equal to R omega was the case when the surface was at rest. What about now? V minus R omega should be V1. Right? Logical? Relative velocity should be zero, or the velocity of the object should be equal to velocity of the surface at the point of contact. What about acceleration? A minus R alpha R will be equal to A1. Okay? Any doubts? Just one more scenario. Draw this. Chupa down. And then wooden scale punishment. I said, got hit anyway? Koi bhi mara tum logo kabhi? No teacher has ever. You got hit, na? See, he is most sincere person. He got hit. This is school only. He got hit. Which is school? St. Joseph's. He got hit. Hey, how bad? Ajay, have you gone kneel down? Knees down? Well, listen, is my dad got hit, my mom got hit. Tum apna batao na, you have anything? He got hit, so he has something to share. Please share it with everyone. This is a thing, okay? This is A1. And we have this map, Abraham map. Her name was Abraham map, so we used to be very, very scared of her. So she just used to pick kids with head and two legs, as I said. It's like mini Fasi. As I said, okay? If you make noise. And yes, somehow girls never got such punishments. They just escaped. But I think Abraham ma'am was gender neutral. She used to pick the दो छोटी बनाए थे ऐसे. So that was the thing we liked about Abraham ma'am. She was gender neutral. Every other teacher was only the boys got it, but Abraham ma'am was nice. All were gender neutral. Delete this while editing. Alright, pay attention here. There is condition for that?
Radius
is R, and Dhyan will tell us how to do it. What? No slipping condition is what? How the variables are related. Do it properly. The point of contact should have the same acceleration as that of the surface in contact. Don't count 50 questions as if I am telling you 50 hours. Alright? And this is like minimum thing, minimum required thing. Alright? And please start preparing for next Kemon test now itself. Now itself. Alright? Acha Kemon test se yaad aaya. Who all have not written Kemon? What? Everybody now wants to know whether you have written or not. Everybody is curious about it. Who has helped to write? Written?
I fell sick again. I think I did write come for the whole hour.
Dengu got over, na?
No, again, like, I fell sick again. I didn't come for
the whole
hour. Dengu? Something like the relapse kind of thing.
The relapse. Alright. Pay attention here and write all the Kemon tests. And next Kemon test, you must prepare now onwards. Let me tell you. What happened? Something you said during your. What happened? You say? How?
How much
you got? Oh, so you're surprised that we got so much. For so less. Listen here. Listen. Do you think that improving school marks is easier or improving the competitive exam's marks at
school?
School is easier, right? So, if suppose one UT, let's say one UT, you don't prepare that well, will you pick it up later on? Do you get time to pick it up? कौन बोला नो निकल जाओ कौन बोला नो दैट प्रोबेबली व्हाट आवर पेरेंट्स मे यूज्ड टू थिंक बिकॉज़ देयर दैट पॉइंट इन टाइम सिनेरियो वाज डिफरेंट नाउ सिनेरियो हैज चेंज्ड ओके सो इट इज आवर ड्यूटी टू मेक देम अवेयर द काइंड ऑफ सिनेरियो वी आर इन इट इज देयर आर पीपल हु हैव स्टडीड वन ओनली फॉर 1 मंथ और 1 एंड 1/2 मंथ क्लास 12 बोर्ड दे हैव गॉट 96-97% ओके इट्स इजी It's very easy. Are you getting it? If you don't score well in UT, I mean, give your best shot in this Kemon test. Most of you have not scored so well till now in any of the Kemon test. And ultimately, this is what will make you go to some good college. Okay? There are scores in these kind of exams. So, do a favor to yourself, prepare for Kemon test only until the next Kemon test, okay? And give your best shot. Don't just get involved in the work related to some monotonous thing like completing the lab records, all those things. Do it in the school itself. All those lab records, complete in the school. Find time somewhere sneaky there and there. Complete it. And there are people who do it. I know there are some class 12 standard kids. You can't imagine the kind of work they have done till now, starting from the day 1 of class 11th. And they are topping in school as well, on top of it. They are doing every work. They still get time. Okay, there are some kids who are doing exceedingly well in bio, physics, chemistry, maths, everything and everywhere. So it is not about time, it is about how much dedicated you are towards a single cause. Okay? Again, you can improve your school marks easily, but not the competitive level exams. Okay? Anyway, so this is rotational kinematics and this is done. Please write down rotational dynamics. This is called RBD. Have you heard of RBD? So till now you were thinking that you are doing rigid body dynamics. Rigid body dynamics has started now itself, just now. Before this, we were doing introduction of system of particles and kinematics of rigid body kinematics. Now we are doing rigid body dynamics. If you if you have noticed, the first two chapters of the class 11th textbook one, book one, get the units and measurement out. After that, first two chapters, kinematics. Kinematics, right? Motion 1D, motion 2D is what? Kinematics. Fine? The concepts of motion 1D, motion 2D are combined and put inside the rotational kinematics. Getting it? Okay? And then other two chapters are laws of motion and work by energy. Laws of motion, work by energy are called the dynamics of the particle. Alright? And we are going to learn how we can use the laws of motion and how we are going to use the work energy concept for a rigid body. Fine? So, as big as laws of motion and as big as work by energy, together they combine, put in this rotational dynamics. Fine? This is what we are going to start. Right? And when you have studied the rotation, the kinematics of a particle, or let's say laws of motion, you have force equal to mass and acceleration, right? What is mass? What is mass? Mass represented inertia. Mass represented inertia. How much amount of force you give to create what amount of acceleration? Okay, larger mass or larger inertia will have lesser acceleration. So that is why force is equal to mass and acceleration. Now, if entire rigid body is just doing translation, for example, this rigid body is just moving like this, is it any different from a particle? No difference, right? All the points have same velocity, same acceleration, so it is no different than a single particle. So you can use force equal to mass and acceleration, and you don't need any other law to analyze this. Are you getting it? Fine. But if it starts rotating while moving, okay, if it starts rotating, then you need to take into account the angular acceleration also. Yes or no? Right? So we need to understand what causes the rotation, not just what causes the translation. By the way, what causes the translation? Force. Force causes translation. So we need to get into the details of rotation now. What causes the rotation? What do you think? What causes the rotation? Have you heard of term called torque? Rotating effect of the force. Right? So we are going to learn about the torque, which is the cause of the angular acceleration. But before you even get into the definition of what is torque, what is the rotational effect of force, we need to also understand what is the inertia against the rotation. Inertia against the translation was mass. Bigger the mass, lesser is the acceleration for the same force. Inertia against rotation is moment of inertia. Okay, just to give you a small example, let's say you have a big rod. Take a big rod and try to rotate from one of its ends. It is very heavy. So rotating from one of ends, you are trying to do that, and then rotating from the center. Which one is easier? Center is easier. So it is easy to rotate from the center than from one of its end. So it means what? It means that inertia against the rotation is changing depending on from where I am rotating the object. Yes or no? Right? So inertia against the rotation has to do with where is the axis of rotation itself. Right? So different axes will have different inertia against the rotation. So that is the reason why we need to study the inertia against the rotation separately, because it can be very tricky. Whereas we never studied mass separately in laws of motion, because mass was very easy, right? Easy to quantify. Right? But we need to quantify inertia against the rotation properly, because at every point different inertia against rotation is there. Alright? So the first topic is inertia against the rotation, and the name of that inertia is called moment of inertia. Please write down moment of inertia. moment of inertia of the masses is this sum of mi ri square. If there are multiple point masses of a system and the distance, the perpendicular distance from the axis of rotation is r1, r2, r3. The moment of inertia is m1, r1 square plus m2, r2 square plus m3, r3 square. Like that. Are you getting it? What is r1, r2, r3? Perpendicular distance from the axis. M1, M2, M3 are the masses for the mass of the point object. Fine? So this is the definition of the moment of inertia. Any doubt here? It's a scalar quantity. Just like mass, it is also inertia. It is a scalar quantity. You don't need to worry about its direction. But yes, moment of inertia depends on which axis you are finding it. Even though it is not a vector, it depends on which axis you are finding the moment of inertia. Getting it? Alright, let's try to do a small numerical on this. Square one, I guess it. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 kg, 2 kg, 3 kg, 4 kg. Okay? You need to find moment of inertia about this axis, where this distance, the side of a square is 2 meters.
Diagonal.
Ajay, what is the perpendicular distance of 2 kg from the axis? Zero. It passes through the axis. Perpendicular distance of 4 kg?
Zero.
Of 1 kg?
Half.
If you draw perpendicular from here, this is the perpendicular distance. How much it is? The diagonal length is how much? Diagonal length is? 2 root 2. So this distance is root 2. Perpendicular distance is root 2. For 1 kg as well as for 3 kg. So what is the moment of inertia? Let me call this is I1 and this is I2. This is I1. So I2 will be 1 into root 2 square plus 3 into root 2 square. So this is 8. Okay? So about which axis it is easy to rotate? I1 or I2? It is easy to rotate about which axis? This one or that one? I2, because inertia is lesser. Got it? What is the moment of inertia about this axis? About this axis, what is the moment of inertia? This one. Do it! About this axis, what is the moment of inertia?
20.
Affirmative, right? Right? Share it in your language. Then don't talk. If you talk, share it with me. Written, continuous distribution of mass, moment of inertia. Tell me an example of continuous distribution of mass. Till now we are dealing with discrete masses. What is a discrete mass, by the way? Point masses. Placed here and there like that. Continuous mass is, for example, this pen. This pen is a continuous mass. Mass is distributed from here till there continuously. Are you getting it? It's not a point mass. It's not a point mass. So how to find moment of inertia of this continuous mass distribution? That is what we are going to do now. You remember center of mass of continuous mass distribution? Remember that? How we have understood that? By dividing the entire mass into small masses of mass dm each. Are you getting it? Similarly, here I'll assume that entire mass is distributed, and entire mass can be divided into point masses of dm each. Okay, and let's say its distance from the axis is r square, so dm r square, summation I have to do. Okay, so this summation becomes integral. Welcome to integral now. R square dm. Okay. So this is the formula for the moment of inertia for a continuous mass. If